Let's look at Tenneco's kinetic hydraulic anti-roll solution. The purpose of an anti-roll solution is to increase roll stiffness, at the same time maintain overall suspension compliancy, so it would be more compliant over a large variety of surfaces. Many have covered Tenneco's kinetic suspension and emphasized the importance of the accumulator, how it plays a role in actively changing pressure to improve roll resistance, allowing softer suspension setup that would be better at absorbing challenging surfaces when a vehicle is not on its roll moment. So we will not be covering on an active accumulator, as there is more to this in the system. For this, kinetic hydraulic anti-roll design works much better when two axles are taken into account, the interconnection. Without emphasizing this, elaboration won't be complete. If we take one axle, then it is very similar to a basic torsion anti-roll bar anti-roll solution, not taking the accumulator into account. However, we can take one axle to look into kinetic's anti-roll properties, but that would only be telling one part of the story, where it does not quite gain an advantage if it were not for the variable pressure active accumulator. It is when all fours are covered, then we can understand why the system is very effective, and that would be how it absorbs rough surfaces while maintaining roll stiffness. It is here where we will focus on, and it is here the system has an advantage, with or without an active accumulator. Let's start with the basics of how a hydraulic anti-roll system works. As a vehicle leans on its own mass, weight, or center of gravity, taking a corner, the left suspension will be on compression, and the right suspension on droop. The hydraulic cylinder to the left, the upper red hydraulic, will be compressed by a piston or positive pressure, and across to the other right suspension, its lower cylinder is also on compression. Because these two cylinders are interconnected, positive pressure starts developing, so a pressure relief chamber is placed. This pressure chamber is called an accumulator and is sprung. On the Tenneco kinetic system, this is active, electronically controlled. Its spring rate decides how stiff the system would be. Opposite or mirror to the red hydraulics is the orange hydraulics, lower left and upper right. It will do exactly the same as the red hydraulics when cornering the other direction. It is on hydraulic tension or negative pressure and can provide roll stiffness as well. The accumulator setting decides roll load or stiffness. Here we can also see a clear advantage if it were a pneumatic pressure chamber, controlling only two parts that would influence all four suspension when a vehicle is on roll and on a straight line when it goes to soft settings or soft mode. Now on to the clever bit, and that is on challenging road surfaces. This is also where all fours work in tandem to get the desired effect. Rough road surfaces rarely affect a wheel in tandem, having two wheels doing the same thing and at the same time, like going over a speed bump. In most cases, it is nearly always asymmetrical, as the nature of these surfaces do not decide the wheelbase or width of a vehicle's design. For this example, we will take one bump to simplify. This would also mean movement of the hydraulic piston on those cylinders would be one at a time. What would happen is, when one wheel is compressed over a bump, that particular hydraulic cylinder will affect six hydraulic cylinders, eight cylinders if we include the hydraulics in the accumulator. It will fill up four red and draw in four orange, because now it has more volume or space to move the hydraulic fluid, filling up and drawing in fluid in and out of those six cylinders. Less of these fluids will move to the accumulator. This means it would have less effect on the accumulator's compression and tension settings, so the suspension that's gone through that bump is less affected by it. It would push and pull the piston or membrane in the accumulator at a much lesser rate than if it were only one axle. On the cylinders, now there is a marker, and the bump will compress and affect the piston or wheel by four notches up. In this example, the cylinder that takes the bump is on the far left. Four notches of this capacity will be divided to the other cylinders and their chamber. As there are eight other chambers in four cylinders, each one will get a notch, four red and four orange, or four compression and four tension. This means only one notch affects both spring on the accumulators, resulting in a reduction in bump load of the affected suspension or wheel. Just compare movement of the piston that is moved by the suspension that is going through a bump and the one that is in the accumulator. It is at a rate of 4 to 1. If we were only to take one extra line, the rate would be 2 to 1, which won't absorb the bump as much. On the interest of performance, included here is this example of when the suspension is loaded into a corner and how the system absorbs disturbances. The focus point being the accumulator's activity to measure how much interruption the bump has caused it while a vehicle is cornering. So in this instance, it will not be affected by much, especially when comparing to a single axle anti-roll solution, and even more so compared to a suspension that has no anti-roll but has the same roll rate. This is the advantage of such a system. Sometimes it is too effective in reducing roll that the setup of a vehicle may suffer too much of a movement in other areas such as pitch, heave and warp because the spring can be made softer. McLaren went around this by adding a so-called active air brake, which also provides a lot of rear downforce under braking and stabilizes center of pressure. This will also hold the rear down against having too much dive during braking, and probably a clever way by McLaren to tackle having too much dive to set up a more compliant ride, which it is famous for. McLaren calls it proactive chassis control, effectively a Tenneco source kinetic anti-roll system with active accumulators and electronically controlled valve on the hydraulic cylinder for it not only to act as anti-roll, but also as a damper.